I talk about character, action, and story, but this time around I'm just gonna skip that because I didn't like the movie. I didn't like it at all, and for me to talk about the movie I will have to spoil it. So just before I go into spoilers, I'm gonna tell you I don't recommend you go to the cinema for this, not even for a reduced price showing. Maybe down the line when it appears on TV or on your Netflix, yeah, check it out, but I would stay away even from that, to be honest. Okay, so I'm gonna go into spoilers now. If you don't wanna get spoiled, just that was my opinion. Don't go, don't watch this. It's horrible. But okay, so what did I think about the movie? First of all, I'm really confused about the whole dinosaurs are dying out again part, because in the previous movies, they had like 3 islands with dinosaurs on them. What happened there? I mean, I don't mean the Jurassic World movie, yeah? That's a new island, Isla Nublar, if I'm correct. But no, the Jurassic Park ones, where they had 3 different islands. Maybe they disregard Maybe they disregard Jurassic Park 2 and 3, so they don't count the islands, but I never understood, so it never came over to me that, that's something that they did, so I'm just very confused what happened to all the dinosaurs on all the other islands. And then it goes back to the very annoying, cliché, typical, nonsensical, oh, they got together at the end of the last movie, but now they broke up and then they have to rekindle. Oh, come on, give me a break. They do that in every darn movie. Just no. Stop doing that in movies. It's horrible. And then they go to the island, back to the island to save the dinosaurs from the exploding volcano, and they spend 15 freaking minutes on the island. That's it, from the whole movie. 15 minutes. And the rest happens in one mansion. So you take the dinosaurs from the island, at least a couple from each species. It's not clear how many dinosaurs they take. A couple from each species, they take it to this mansion in the UK, and then the rest of the movie is there because they want to free them there. I mean, come on, it's Jurassic World. Everything happens in one mansion. It's just so annoying and so stupid. And then there, everything turns into a creature feature. I mean, I understand, yes, Jurassic Park is, well, a monster movie. It has that at the basis. But for the love of Mike, we barely see any of the dinosaurs there. They just show off a couple of the dinosaurs and then, oh, but there's this super bad dinosaur that we engineered. And it is sort of a mix from the previous, the Indominus Rex, and then just the Raptor, which is, that's why they needed Blue. They needed her genetic material. But then it's smaller than the Indominus Rex, and it also doesn't have all the fancy gadgety stuff that they put, so like the invisibility or the heat cloak and all that stuff. They don't play any of that up. It's just a monster-looking thing that is haunting them that is somewhat smart. It's just, Jesus, Lord mercy, it's so stupid. And then this dinosaur, he can climb up the roof of the building and somehow hang down and open the door upside down and then jump down. It's just, Lord mercy, it's so silly. And I know, I shouldn't be shocked or anything if a movie is stupid, but it's seriously. To talk a little bit about the cast, the kid from Get Down plays the tech nerd. I really liked Get Down and liked the kid in it, but here he just doesn't fit as a tech nerd. He's just annoying and out of place. And there's another girl who's sort of a biologist, and she just couldn't act at all. She was all over the place. It just, no, didn't work for me, not even a little bit. What I forgot to mention is the title of the movie, The World, comes in at the end, where they actually let the dinosaurs go, at least some of them who survived or who weren't sold off at the mansion. And from there, they somehow spread throughout the world, and that's why we have the Jurassic World now as a title, because it was absolutely unclear how many dinosaurs they took from the island to the mansion, and then at the end of the movie they let all the dinosaurs go, and from there apparently they're supposed to populate the whole world, but we only saw a couple of cars and one ship taking dinosaurs from the island to the mansion, so it's just, it's super stupid. At the end, they throw in like a clone child story, who was the clone granddaughter of one of the older people who started up Jurassic Park. Why? This is something that can be gone deep on. It could be a deep story, but no, it's just a throwaway plot line that just makes no sense at all. So Oh, no, no, definitely stay away from this movie. Yeah, if you want to talk about visuals and actions, yeah, there are good things in there. So, as I said, it's a good sort of creature feature. I was still tense here and there, but this was just annoying tenseness, and I was finding myself thinking, why is this happening and when is this gonna be over? Because I couldn't take it anymore. Usually, yeah, this is not how I review, but I just really wanted to rant about this. So I hope you guys don't mind that too much, and I'm gonna go back to my scripted stuff from now on. But yeah, I just needed to let loose of this one, because I don't know, curiously enough, I really enjoyed Jurassic World, the previous movie. I didn't expect to enjoy it, but I really thought it was fun. And when I already saw the trailer that they take them off the island, I was like, oh, please, Lord, no, don't do this. Anyways, see you guys next time when I see hopefully a movie that's worth more reviewing. Have a great day. Bye-bye.